Hello friends, let's start the discussion on questions of composition scheme. I am going to take some important questions. Yes, total there are 39 questions and 41 MCQs. So let's discuss some important questions in this MCQ. I hope you already have read this chapter before continuing this session. और आपको जहाँ तक है आपने रिवाइज कर लिया है अमेंडमेंट्स के साथ, बिकॉज यस इफ यू आर नॉट डन द अमेंडमेंट फर्स्ट डू दैट विच आई हैव अपलोडेड इन हिंदी एज वेल एज इन इंग्लिश. सो इंग्लिश फॉर स्पेशली साउथ स्टूडेंट्स, सो फर्स्ट डू दैट एंड देर आफ्टर ओके लेट्स कंप्लीट कंपोजिशन स्कीम. दिस क्वेश्चन हैज फर्स्ट विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस question number 5. Explain provision. In accordance with the provision of GST Act pertaining to composition scheme, can registered person who purchases the goods from a taxable person paying tax under composition scheme avail credit of tax paid on purchases made from composition dealer? Very simple question. I am purchasing the goods from a supplier who has opted for composition scheme. Can I take credit of whatever the tax he has paid under composition scheme? Obviously no, because he will give bill of supply in which no GST has been charged, and I cannot take the ITC of that. So answer obviously better no. If I purchase the goods from composition dealer, then I can't take ITC of that. Second, can a person paying tax under composition scheme issue a tax invoice under GST? No. Okay, there is a bill of supply. As you know, there are two composition scheme for your attempt. Composition scheme under section 10 and composition scheme under notification 2/2019. So in both the cases, tax invoice is not there. Okay, you have to issue bill of supply. Now third, are monthly returns required to be filed by a person opting to pay tax under composition scheme? No, beta, quarterly return. But now new notification is there that yearly return, but in your statutory update they have not covered this provision. Means this yearly return, annual return for composition scheme not applicable for your exam. Hence, okay, you must write quarterly return for composition scheme. Next, can a person who has opted to pay tax under composition scheme avail ITC? Again, no, he cannot avail ITC, because one of the drawback of composition scheme, or you can say one of the condition of composition scheme, you cannot take the ITC. Okay, for payment of tax under composition rate. So this is question number 5, very simple. Thereafter question numbers, thereafter next question. Question number 6. In accordance with the provision of GST Act, give answer to the following pertaining to composition scheme. Whether composition scheme is optional or compulsory? If you read the text of section 10.1, then okay, you will find registered person may opt to pay tax under composition scheme. Hence the scheme is optional and not mandatory. Okay, so this scheme is not mandatory. Next, a taxable person, okay, next, a taxable person having PAN can opt to pay tax under composition scheme by seeking separate registration for branches having same PAN. Again, answer is no. You cannot separately apply composition scheme branches wise or separate registration wise. In proviso to section 10.3, there is one condition, and what is that? If you opt for composition scheme for one branch, then applicable to all, or If anyone is not eligible to take composition scheme all over India, then all branches, okay, will not fall within the scope of composition scheme. अगर एक को composition scheme नहीं मिली तो और किसी को नहीं मिलेगा, और अगर एक लेगा तो सबको ही लेना पड़ेगा. If you log in regular class or fast track class, अगर तू है तो पूरी कायदे है, अगर तू नहीं तो कुछ नहीं. Okay, so on that basis applicable to all, otherwise not anybody else. Next, can composition scheme be availed? Sorry, third, will taxable person will be eligible to offer composition scheme only for one out of three business unit? Answer is same, no. He has to apply composition scheme for all, otherwise not available to any establishment. Question number 4. Can composition scheme be availed if taxable person effect interstate supplies? No. If you remember section 10-2, one of the condition is that you cannot do interstate supply of goods under section 10. If you are under, okay, composition scheme under section 10, so you cannot do interstate supply of the goods. But I want to bring your attention on the point. Just a minute. I am going to open regular notes on this composition. In 10-2, okay, there are various conditions. First, you are not engaged in supply of service. Second, you are not engaged in making non-taxable supply. C condition, he is not engaged in making interstate outward supply of goods. Supply of goods. So there is one question yesterday I have seen in WhatsApp. Ki sir, as per amended provision, I repeat, as per amended provision, supply of services allowed by manufacturer or restaurant or catering or other traders with permissible limit of 10% of turnover in state. I repeat, 10% of turnover in state or rupees 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. So itne limit tak aap service de sakte ho. Now, okay, sir, my question here, ki I am not doing any interstate supply of goods, but yes, whatever the service which is allowed to me, that 10% or 5 lakhs, I am doing some interstate supply of services under section 10. You are under section 10. So, what is my question? Can I do interstate supply of services within permissible limit? Yes. Because this restriction is only for goods, not for service. So I think that, okay, I personally think that, ki yes, this is a loophole, or government forgot to amend this 10-2. According to me, yahan pe jo hona chahiye tha, goods and services hona chahiye tha, but government here forget to consider the word services, only they have taken goods. So okay, I can say this is the loophole of the act. Ye act ka complete loophole hai. To aap iska benefit le sakte ho. And now in this case, there is a restriction only on supply of goods, not on service. That means you can't do interstate supply of goods. But within permissible limit of 10% or 5 lakhs, you can do interstate supply of services. So yes, keep in mind this point. Again, I turn to my discussion. Can composition tax be collected from customer? No. You cannot collect composition tax from customer because of the condition. You cannot take the credit. You cannot pass the credit. Okay. So, this is related to that question number 6. Next, question number 8. XYZ Limited is a manufacturing company located in Bangalore. During the financial year 2018, total value of supply including inward supplies tax under reverse charge basis is 1 crore 54 lakhs. Breakup of these supplies are intrastate supplies of goods chargeable to nil rate 25 lakhs, under forward charge 85 lakhs, intrastate supply of exempted goods 19 lakhs, inward supplies on which tax payable under RCM 25 lakhs. Explain whether XYZ Limited is eligible to opt for composition scheme. in a financial year 1920. So try to understand. Here, year 1920 is a current financial year and data is given for 1819. You have to just fix whether composition scheme is eligible or not. As per amended provision, I repeat, as per amended provision, okay, now if aggregate turnover of preceding financial year does not exceeds 1.5 CR, then in current year, you are eligible for composition scheme. You are eligible for composition scheme. Point number two, how to calculate aggregate turnover? As per the definition given in CGST Act, aggregate turnover includes all exempt supply, all taxable supply, exempt supply including nil rated, wholly exempted and non-taxable supply, export supply and interstate supply. That means for calculation of aggregate turnover, you also have to add nil rate and wholly exempt supply. But, okay, does not include inward supply which is subject to payment of RCM. So, this aggregate turnover, another important condition, this aggregate turnover all over India pan basis. Matlab, aggregate turnover of all branches. So, in this case, okay, this definition first I have given for aggregate turnover. In this case, you have to consider 25, 85, 19 but not 25 lakhs. So, your total turnover is 1 crore 54 lakhs. Out of that, you have to deduct 25 lakhs because which is not to be considered for calculation of aggregate turnover. So, okay, your net turnover in this case is 1 crore 29 lakhs, which is less than 1.5 CR. You are eligible for, okay, to opt for composition scheme. You are eligible to opt for composition scheme. Next, question number 9. See, a dealer X has two offices in Delhi. How to determine whether X is eligible to avail benefit of composition scheme? Has turnover of both the offices for financial year 36 lakhs or 42 lakhs respectively. Now, you have to consider aggregate turnover. And if your aggregate turnover in preceding financial year does not exceed 1.5 CR, then you are eligible for composition scheme in current financial year. This aggregate turnover all over India pan basis. So, in this case, okay, a turnover of these two branches is 78 lakhs, which is below 1.5 CR. Hence, you can opt for composition scheme. Another one, office is in Delhi. Hence, there is no problem. But if these offices are located in special category of state other than Assam, Himachal Pradesh and then applicable limit is 75 lakhs. So here question may be, okay, it could be asked in another way. What is, ki, would your answer differ if both the branches or any one of the branches located in special category of state? Perhaps you will find such type of question. So yes, in that case, my answer definitely will differ because in special category of state, okay, applicable limit is 75 lakhs. In given case, it is 70 lakh exceeds. Or if any one branch is in special category of state, then also, okay, composition scheme is not available because take example, my one branch in Mizoram. So aggregate turnover for Mizoram exceeds 75 lakhs. If that branch is not eligible to take composition scheme, then any other branch is also not, okay, go for this composition scheme. So this is very important here, okay, regarding to composition scheme in this problem. Next, question number 11. Determine whether supplier in the following cases eligible for composition scheme levy, provided that their turnover in preceding year does not exceed 1.5 CR. Mohan is engaged in providing legal services in Rajasthan and is registered in same state. So here purely engaged in supply of service and not a manufacturer, trader or other supplier. Purely engaged in supply of service. Hence composition scheme under section 10 is not available. Huh. Composition scheme under Section 10 is available if you supply the goods along with services, but under 10 is not available. In my notes, I have given the answer as per Section 10. As per Section 10. But if you apply notification to 2019, come on, that is a new notification to 2019, then supplier of service can apply for composition scheme if aggregate turnover of preceding financial year does not exceed 50 lakhs. So in this case, okay, they are not clearly, okay, in question they are not clearly given, okay, whether we have to answer as per Section 10 or notification to 2019. Even though in my questionnaire I have given answer as per Section 10, but you can add one note, okay, aap ek note add kar sakte ho ki in Section 10 is not available, but under notification to 2019, if aggregate turnover of preceding financial year does not exceed 50 lakhs, then he can offer composition scheme. Okay, he can offer composition scheme. पर इसमें एक और बात है, legal service है और legal service reverse charge में होती है. तो depend on facts of the case, क्योंकि most of the legal service वो individual advocate reverse charge में होती है. तो ऐसे केस में question of composition scheme does not arise because recipient is liable to pay tax, but उसमें यहाँ clear नहीं दिया है, इसलिए अभी आप ये कहना कि notification to 2019 के हिसाब से वो composition scheme ले सकता है. but ओके, मैं इसको और थोड़ा डिटेलिंग करूँ तो डिटेलिंग में बेटा मैं आपको इतना ही कहूँगा कि ये रिवर्स चार्ज में आती है लीगल सर्विस, और ये बंदा एडवोकेट होगा, क्योंकि एडवोकेट वहाँ दिया नहीं है, ये बंदा एडवोकेट होगा तो रिवर्स चार्ज वाले के केस में कंपोजिशन का क्वेश्चन ही नहीं आता है. पर अगर ये एडवोकेट नहीं होगा, यस वो इफ ही इज़ नॉट एन एडवोकेट, इन दैट केस यस ही कैन ऑफर टू 2019. पर इन करेक्शन शीट, एक्चुअली इट इज़ नॉट एन मिस्टेक, बट इन करेक्शन शीट, ओके, आई हैव एडेड वन कमेंट इन दिस आंसर कि एज पर नोटिफिकेशन टू 2019, ओके, इफ टर्न ओवर बिलो 50 लैक्स कंपोजिशन स्कीम इज अवेलेबल. यू विल गेट दिस करेक्शन शीट, ओके, अगेन ऑन www.vsmartacademy.com/vishal sir. आई रिपीट, इज इज नॉट अ मिस्टेक, ओके, आई एम जस्ट एडिंग एडिशनल पॉइंट फॉर यूर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ओके, सेकेंड वन, सुगम मैन्युफैक्चर हैज रजिस्टर्ड ऑफिस इन पंजाब एंड हरियाणा and supplies goods on neighboring state. Again, okay, interstate supply, as I told you, in case of interstate supply of goods, this, okay, composition levy is not available. Third, can supplier of service offer composition levy under Section 10? No. Answer is given as per Section 10. Under Section 10, no, if he is exclusively supplier of service. But, okay, if he supply service with goods, then available within permissible limit. Okay. But you can add one point here, which I have not added in questionnaire, but I will give a correction sheet after adding this one note. You will find all these things, okay, in correction sheet. Is it clear? You can download from www.vsmartacademy.com/vishal sir. I am not going to repeat again this thing, okay. But you can add one thing, as per notification to 2009, yes, you can go for composition scheme if aggregate turnover or preceding financial does not relax. Last one, can person paying tax under composition scheme make supplies of goods to SEZ? As per the provision of IGST, if you supply any goods to SEZ, then it would be treated as interstate supply. Come on, it would be treated as interstate supply. So in this case, okay, interstate supply as per Section 10(2) does not allowed. Means if you supply the goods to SEZ, then composition scheme is not available. I repeat, composition scheme is not available. I hope you understood. Then this is regarding to composition scheme. Next, question number 14. Laksh Limited is a manufacturing company located in Karnataka, has been registered under composition scheme, furnishes the following information for the financial year 2018 and 2019. Okay, it requires you to determine its composition tax liability and total tax liability in financial year 18-19. Total value of supplies including inward supplies tax under reverse charge basis 82 lakhs. The breakup of supplies is as follows. Intrastate supplies of auto spare V unit chargeable 12% GST. Intrastate supplies auto spare X unit chargeable 5% GST. Inward supplies on which tax payable under RCM 12%, 6,40,000. And intrastate supplies wholly exempt under the section 11 of CGST Act 15,60,000. And SEC is a manufacturer. Come on, SEC is a manufacturer. Now, some important points of this case study. Before going ahead, read the provision properly in your book. Thereafter, try to solve this question. Don't immediately jump. Okay, on the answers. Don't immediately jump. Okay, remember the things which required this problem. Don't do that. Go slowly and carefully. Yes. Open this chapter, the step number one, from your regular book. Open this chapter, composition scheme. First, read that section 10.1. Okay, repetitively. Okay, keep that notes in front of you, regular notes in front of you, and start to read that section 10.1. Here, questionnaire is not just to read. Whatever the questions are given in questionnaire, first time you must try it by yourself with the help of notes. Even though these lectures are complementary, but you must follow some steps. Step number one. Have you read that section 10, subsection 1? In which the first condition, aggregate turnover of preceding financial year does not exceed 1.5 CR, then composition scheme is available. Now, tax payable by the manufacturer 1% of turnover in state. This second step. Now, open this definition of turnover in state. Turn to that definition, turnover in state. Read that definition carefully. Turnover in state. All taxable supplies except supply under RCM. Second, exempt supplies, exports, and interstate in that state. So, here you have completed first step. But in section 10.1, if you read that carefully, then the second line in bare text, the second line is, subject to provision of section 9.4, 9.3 and 9.4, you may go for this composition scheme. Have you read that general provisions? Now, again read this problem. Try to understand the facts carefully. Go slowly, carefully for some problems. Then and only then you will get a complete grip on this topic, composition levy. If you see the facts of this case, then they have not asked the question here about eligibility of composition scheme. They already stated ki Laksh Limited has opted for composition scheme. That means this problem does not base on for deciding eligibility. Step number two, we have to calculate tax. So you already assume that eligible for composition scheme and have to calculate the tax for current financial year. Okay. Next, a manufacturer. Okay. In given case, SEC is a manufacturer. For manufacturer, tax to be calculated 1% of turnover in state. Now, open your regular book. What I had explained at the time of regular session, do you remember that? I afraid no. Okay. If you remember, yes, right, for manufacturer and restaurant and catering, you have to add exempt supply and nil rate supply also for calculation of 1%. For trader, only taxable supply of goods and services, but for manufacturer and restaurant catering, 1% of turnover in state, and it includes this exempt and nil rate. Yes. Okay, I have no concern with another supply like non-taxable, interstate and etc. Why? If in composition scheme, if you do those supplies, then you are not eligible for this levy. Matlab, composition levy shall be withdrawn. Go slowly. Hence, from that definition of turnover in state, only three supplies are important. Taxable, nil rate and exempt. Okay, so for calculation of 1% in current financial year up to 1.5 CR, you have to take this, okay, intrastate supply, second intrastate supply, which is at normal rate 5%, but we have no concern with normal rate, and intrastate supply which is wholly exempt. Yes, you also have to consider intrastate supply which is wholly exempt. Okay, so for these supplies, your total is 24 lakhs, 36 lakhs, don't consider inward supplies subject to RCM, because it should not be taken for turnover in state. Intrastate supply which is wholly exempt, total 75,60,000, 1% composition tax you have to calculate. Ignore normal rate. But if you remember, composition levy is applicable subject to provision of 9.3 and 9.4. What it means? It means whatever the tax payable under reverse charge, you cannot apply composite rate. Thus, on that reverse charge service, you have to pay tax completely at normal rate. So, on that inward supply under RCM, I have calculated the GST at normal rate, and that is 12%. So, okay, if you remember my regular session, maine ye kaha tha कि मैं अपनी शादी तो रजिस्टर मैनेज कर रहा हूँ, पर मेरे साले की शादी दैट इज़ अंडर रिवर्स चार्ज, ओके, मुझे धूमधाम से करना पड़ेगा, मतलब मुझे पूरा 12% का टैक्स देना पड़ेगा. ओके, सो दिस इज़ द प्रॉब्लम. सो व्हाट इज़ द स्पेशल एडजस्टमेंट्स इन दिस प्रॉब्लम? स्पेशल एडजस्टमेंट इन दिस प्रॉब्लम दैट, ओके, हियर, यस, under reverse charge you have to pay full tax and calculation of turnover in state for manufacturer. Now another homework for you. Would your answer differ in this case if supplier under composition scheme is trader? Yes? What do you think? Obviously. Why? Because for trader, the 1% limit is on taxable supply of goods or services in a state. In that situation, only on 24 plus 36, on these two elements, tax would have been payable. Otherwise not. Then, so this is one of the good problem. Now, if whatever I told you, you followed the steps, then here you can write legal provision also properly, whatever is the format of your question. Okay, institute in exam, every exam continuously changing the format, sometimes MCQ, case study based MCQ or blah 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 blah, forget it. Whatever is the format of the MCQ, leave it. If you are conceptually clear, then definitely you can handle any format of the question. how to increase conceptual understanding beta? So in this case, steps I told you, if don't try yourself to remember the things, it will create the tension. I repeat, it will create the tension. So first, open your book, read that respective provision repetitively with frequent revision and take a grip, and then decide the structure on that basis. Don't try to remember. Go slowly. Don't try to remember. Then decide the structure of that, and then refer the answer of this questionnaire, and thereafter fix the format in your mind. If you do this practice continuously, then and only then you will get that level of confidence what institute require. I hope you understood. So in every problem, follow this practice. Open the book. Don't try to remember. Don't try to recollect. Go step by step. बेटा अभी मेरा मूड बहुत अच्छा है, जब मैं रिकॉर्डिंग कर रहा हूँ तो मैं आपको ये स्टेप्स बता रहा हूँ. ओके, नो डाउट मेरा शेड्यूल बहुत टाइट है अभी. कंसल्टेंसी, देन अमेंडमेंट्स, देन IPC अमेंडमेंट्स, GST इज कंटिन्यूसली चेंजिंग, और मैं दिन में 10 से 12 घंटा वर्क करके रिकॉर्डिंग कर रहा हूँ. बट मैं आपको यही कहूँगा, अभी जस्ट मैं एक घंटे का नैप लेके उठा हूँ तो आपके लिए रिकॉर्डिंग कर रहा हूँ बेटा. ओके, ये क्वेश्चन है उसके. बट यू इफ यू फॉलो दिस स्टेप्स तो आपके लिए कोई प्रॉब्लम बड़ा प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. ठीक है, डन. ओके, दिस प्रॉब्लम इज ओवर. इट्स बेटर इन दिस प्रॉब्लम टेक अ चिट. ओके, इन योर नोट्स राइट लीगल प्रोविजन, दैट वुड बी मोर बेटर. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई हैव टेकन डायरेक्टली here total of exam supply. If you write a note that try to understand, if you write the note ki manufacturer has to pay 1% of turnover in state which includes the three elements on RCM, you cannot apply composition scheme, separate tax is payable, so it would be more better for you. So okay, do that, take a cheat, write the okay some notes whatever you referred from the book and complete this case study. Done. Okay, this question is over. Next, question number 15. Mr. Amar is running consultancy firm. Oho, consultancy firm. And also ready-made garments showroom, which are registered under the same PAN. Turnover of the showroom is rupees 55 lakhs and receipt of consultancy firm is 15 lakhs in preceding financial year. Whether Mr. Amar is eligible for composition scheme here under section 10, under section 10, whether there is any difference if Mr. Amar want to opt for composition only for the showroom. Okay, if instead of consulting agency Mr. Amar is running a restaurant, whether he is eligible for composition scheme. Third, if turnover of the garment showroom 1.5 crore in preceding financial year and there is no consultancy firm, whether he is eligible for composition scheme. Okay, don't gear up the activity, just go slowly, get relaxed. आपको टाइम लग रहा होगा, लगने दो, बट गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप. डोंट रीड द क्वेश्चन, इट इज माय स्ट्रिक्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन. नाउ ओके, अगेन ओपन द बुक सेक्शन 10(1). Read that section 10(1). Okay, manufacturer, restaurant and catering. Come on, manufacturer, restaurant and catering. And third, manufacturer, restaurant and catering. And third, other supplier. Applicable rate is given. Second step, as per proviso, supply of service is allowed. As per proviso, supply of service is allowed अप टू 10% ऑफ टर्नओवर इन स्टेट और रुपीज 5 लाख विच एवर इज हायर 5 लाख विच एवर इज हायर. डन बेटा. नेक्स्ट ओके यू हैव रीड द 10-1. ठीक है. नाउ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन whether Mr. Amar is eligible for composition scheme. What would be your answer? Yes, try it. Updating the provision. He is supplying the goods of 55 lakhs and receive from the services 15 lakhs. Receive from the services 15 lakhs. So in they ask the question on eligibility of composition scheme. That means this data is of preceding financial year and you have to fix the eligibility. Next, the turnover of preceding financial year, goods 55 and 15 lakhs, if you make the total below 1.5 CR, what is their question? Whether under section 10 can they apply for composition scheme. Here as per proviso you can supply the services within permissible limit in preceding financial year, but whether the service of 15 lakhs consultancy firm is within permissible limit is not how to calculate, because whether 10% or 5 lakhs whichever is higher, but whether it is within permissible limit we can't do that unless we get the data of preceding financial year of last year of this preceding financial year, because already this data is of preceding financial year. And if you going to calculate 10% of turnover in state of preceding financial year, means you need the data of turnover in state of last financial year of that preceding financial year. Done? So go slowly, careful. So data is not available whether service is within permissible limit or not. Therefore your answer is depend on assumption. In my questionnaire I have said no. Okay, in questionnaire I have said no, you can't avail the scheme, because first I have referred that notification of that proviso. Okay, so I have given the answer like that, not eligible, because I assume the 15 lakhs is more than permissible limit. But you can write the answer in another way also, depends on your assumption that if rupees 15 lakhs is within permissible limit of 10% of turnover in state or 5 lakhs whichever is higher, then composition scheme is available. So how you take assumption, on that basis you must have to write your answer. Hence beta, don't WhatsApp me about this. It depends on your what. Yes, assumption. Next question here, whether there is any difference if Mr. Amar want to opt for composition scheme only for showroom. No. Okay, why? Because if you supply the services more than permissible limit, then you are not eligible for composition scheme for any particular branch. For that, open your regular book. Don't jump immediate. Okay, don't presume that you knew that concept. Go repetitive revision. You don't know anything, go repetitive revision. Open the book again, read that proviso. What is that proviso? That proviso here, that proviso, what is that? If you remember my dialogue, tu hai to puri kainat hai, tu nahi to kuch nahi, means composition scheme is available to all branches. You cannot select individually. अगर मिलेगा तो सबको मिलेगा, अदरवाइज किसको नहीं मिलेगा. सो इन सच केस यू कैन नॉट टेक दिस स्कीम सेपरेटली फॉर एनी पर्टिकुलर ब्रांच. हेंस आंसर इज नो. यू ओके ओनली फॉर शोरूम ही कैन नॉट ऑफर कंपोजिशन स्कीम. नेक्स्ट बी, इफ इंस्टेड ऑफ कंसल्टिंग एजेंसी मिस्टर अमर इज रनिंग अ रेस्टोरेंट, वेदर इज एलिजिबल फॉर कंपोजिशन स्कीम. Open your book again. Don't presume that you know the provision. Open your book. Under section 10.1, provision of section 10.1, see that proviso. What the proviso said? Supply of service is allowed in bracket other than clause B of para 6 of schedule 2. Up to 10% or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. In that bracket, other than means what? In amendment, I told you, don't misunderstood this. That other than means, restaurant and catering you can supply without a limit. For that, this permissible limit provision is not applicable. Clear? Without limit you can supply this. So okay, here if you provide restaurant and catering, then permissible limit is not applicable and composition scheme is available, provided that your turnover below 1.5 crore. So my answer, restaurant service are eligible for composition scheme. You can write here for your purpose without limit. Without limit. Hence, Mr. Amar is eligible for composition scheme and as per 10.2A, exception is given only to this category. As per section 10.2A. If you see 10.2 exception is given to this category means, open that 10.2 conditions. So otherwise provided under section 10.1. That so otherwise provided under section 10.1 means you can supply restaurant service as well as you can supply other services within permissible limit. Hence the reference of 10.2A is taken here. Next, third question. If the turnover of garment showroom is 1.5 crore in preceding financial year and there is no consultancy firm, whether he is eligible for composition scheme? If he is exclusively engaged in supply of goods, exclusively engaged in supply of goods, then yes, he is eligible for composition scheme. Okay. Also, services is allowed up to within permissible limit. So, okay, exclusively engaged in the goods and supply allowed. Make the correction here. Answer is correct, eligible for composition scheme, but by mistake, no came here, you have to write yes, he is eligible for composition services. Done. So this problem is over here. Question number 21, under what circumstances the composition scheme shall be withdrawn? Yes, don't try to jump. Open your book, recollect the thing from the book. Read that provision again. While solving the question of composition scheme, you must have to open your regular book for 50 times, not 100 times, but for 50 times. Whenever there is a new question, open your book. Don't try to recollect. Don't try to remember. If you read that topic 50 times for every questions, I assured you, you will get the clear structure about the presentation, about the legal provision and how to answer the questions. Don't just read the questionnaire. Okay. So, beta, under what circumstances composition scheme shall be withdrawn? The first is when your turnover exceeds 1.5 crores in current financial year, aggregate turnover. Second, if you don't fulfill the condition of 10-2, do you remember? Yes. If you don't fulfill the condition of 10-2, third, yes, come on. Third, 10-2, whatever the conditions, you do interest rate supply, more than services, more than permissible limit, issue supply of the goods, non-taxable supply, notified manufacture of the goods. In that case, composition schemes can be withdrawn. CTP, NRTP. Okay, so all this, okay, has been covered here. Also, if you purchase the goods from unregistered person, that condition is also given in rule. CTP and NRTP condition is also given. So these are certain circumstances where composition scheme shall be withdrawn. Okay, so from regular book, you have read that answers in mind, arrange that answer, read the answer given in questionnaire and design the format. Don't try to recollect. Just design the format at every time. I hope you understood. Next, question number 26. This question, based on notification 2/2019, which is the amendment, okay, for your exam. Hyundai Service Center, a supplier of service registered under GST in the state of Maharashtra, provide car servicing to various customers at intrastate level. The turnover of preceding financial year 17-18 was rupees 45 lakhs. Okay, preceding financial year 45 lakhs. The turnover of first quarter of current financial year 18-19, 40 lakhs, which includes 30 lakhs for provision of service and 18 lakhs for the sale of goods, such as spare parts and etc. State whether Hyundai Service Center can offer composition scheme in current financial year. Determine the tax liability under notification to 2019. Again, don't jump. Don't try to recollect. Open. First of all, in this case, supplier of supplier is a service provider. Hence, open notification to 2019. Now, your question, sir, how we could assess that this question based on notification to 2019, because the start of this question is predominantly supplier is engaged in supply of services. Clear? Hence, section 10(1) is not applicable, because that is applicable for manufacturer, restaurant and catering, and other supplier who supply somewhat services within permissible limit. In this case, the main supply is of services. Now, for 2 minutes, read that notification. Okay, pause my lecture. Read that notification to 2019. If you have done that, then you will find 2/2019 is applicable for all registered person who is not eligible to get composition scheme under section 10(1). So first, write down the provision of 2/2019. Second, aggregate turnover of preceding financial year does not exceed 50 lakhs. In given case, 40 lakhs is there. Go slowly. Keep that book in front of you and then read this question. Then design the answers. Don't try to recollect. Slowly. Okay. So aggregate turnover, applicable rate is 6%, and all other similar conditions, that interest rate, neonachi, CTP, NRTP, and etc. I hope you remember. So in given case, after writing notification 2/2019, the legal provision, you can say composition scheme is available, and in current year you have to calculate the tax at the rate 6%. 6% of first supply, the word uses first supply of goods or services. Now, under notification 2/2019, along with supply of services, there is no restriction for supply of goods. You can also supply the goods, and on that aggregate value which is below 50 lakhs in current financial year, you can opt for composition scheme. Then also there is no limit ki along with service you can provide the goods only to up to certain this limit and etc. No. Under section 10(1) you will find that limit ki 10% etc. along with goods. But under notification along with service there is no limit like this. You can supply the goods without any restriction. So for goods and services, both, that is 48 lakhs, applicable rate is 3%. You can take, instead of normal rate, you can take 3% plus 3%, 6% of the first supply. Done, beta? Okay. Next, question number 27, I already covered in amendment notes. So you can do from amendments, or here I will attach the discussion of amendment notes on this question. But it's my suggestion ki if you have done amendments on composition levy, then you can continue from that amendment notes. This problem already we have covered in amendment notes. Okay, so I'm not going to take here. Question number 27. Next, question number 28. Very good question. Important. So this question is important question. Mr. Rohan, a trader registered under GST Act, has opted for a composition scheme, engage in supply of goods or services. Has opted, that means data is clear ki going for composition scheme. Details of transaction carried out by him in preceding financial year 18-19 and current financial year 19-20 as given below. Determine aggregate turnover and GST liability of first quarter of current financial year 19-20 from the given information. Okay, so you have to determine GST liability. Okay, different states are given, Maharashtra, Goa, Madhya Pradesh. Goods and services, their turnover is given. Turnover of goods includes taxable exempt nil rate, okay. Services taxable exempt, okay. Turnover in state is also given. This data of 18-19. Now assess is a trader. Okay. Next, turnover in state is given. One note is given below, the service provided is within the limit of 10% of turnover in state or rupees 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. Okay. Next, current financial year, taxable and exempt turnover for different state is given. You have to determine the aggregate turnover and tax liability of preceding financial year. So now, don't jump. Go step by step. Go slowly. Open your book. Yes, open your book. Read that 10-1. If aggregate turnover of preceding financial year does not exceed 1.5 CR, then you are eligible for composition scheme in current financial year. For trader in a third category, 1% of taxable supply of goods and services in a state. Taxable supply of goods or services in a state. Proviso. You can supply the services within permissible limit in preceding financial year also and in current financial year also. So, in preceding financial year, they have supplied the services. While taking aggregate turnover, you have to take 3 supplies. All taxable supplies of goods or services, exempt supplies and nil rate supplies. Okay. Have you read that provision? So, preceding financial year, you have to take aggregate turnover. Now, the next question. Whatever the data given for services, whether it is in permissible limit, because if in preceding financial year you supply the services above permissible limit, then composition scheme is not available. How you come to know ki this supply of services is within permissible limit? For that, in question, if you see the note below, this question itself says it is within permissible limit. Yes, it is within permissible limit. That means, aggregate turnover of all over India basis of goods and services, which includes taxable, exempt and nil rate, total, is 150 lakhs. Come on, it's capita, 150 lakhs, aggregate turnover. So, eligible for composition scheme under section 10-1. Don't jump on notification 2-2019. First try under section 10-1. If under section 10-1 you are not eligible, then go to notification 2-2019. But under section 10-1 you are eligible. Clear? 10-1 you are eligible. Okay. Next. So, you are eligible for composition scheme. You have to calculate the tax for current financial year. Current financial year, you have to take 1% of taxable supply of goods or services. I repeat, 1% of taxable supply of goods or services. So, this taxable supply you have to consider, and your services must be within permissible limit. Now, very, very important criteria. What is that? This permissible limit for services in current financial year, 10% of turnover in that state or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher, is available state-wise, because they have taken a 10% of turnover in state. So, it is available state-wise, not aggregate. Might be some student, कुछ लोग ये कंफ्यूज हो सकते हैं कि 10% पूरा इंडिया का मिला के या 5 लाख पूरा इंडिया का मिला के, नहीं, 10% जो है स्टेट, 10% और 5 लाख विच एवर इज अवेलेबल, ये सर्विस जो है वो आपको स्टेट वाइज मिलेगा. एंड योर एग्रीगेट टर्नओवर शुड नॉट एक्सीड्स फॉर सप्लाई ऑफ ऑल गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज अबव 1.5 CR. सो for Maharashtra, decide the permissible limit of services. I have more concern with services. Last year turnover, because 10% of turnover in state of preceding financial year. Last year turnover, total turnover in state is 12 lakhs. So 12 lakhs ka 10% and 1.2 lakhs or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher, is allowed. See this presentation carefully. Try to solve the problem on the basis of this presentation. So here taxable supply 20 lakhs, exempt supply 10 lakhs, total 30 lakhs, step by step. Okay, for services, allowed limit 5 lakhs or 1.2 lakhs, whichever is higher, that is 5 lakhs. Obviously, I have directly taken 5 lakhs. Your actual supply of service, again, actual supply of service is 2 plus 1, 3 lakhs. 3 lakhs. So, limit available 5 lakhs and your supply of services is 3 lakhs. Now, be careful. Come on, be careful. For a calculation of permissible limit, you have to take, read that proviso again. Read that proviso again. Open your book. That proviso says, provided that, okay, you can supply any service, in the first line they have used the word any service, up to 10%. That means that 10% limit is applicable for all services, the taxable plus exempt, including both the services, your amount should not exceed 10% or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. So, for deciding whether you are within permissible limit of services, very good problem. Whether you are within permissible limit of services, you have to take taxable plus exempt, total is 3 lakhs. Don't get confused. Total is 3 lakhs. Yes, it is within permissible limit. Second, so turnover of your services, and your tax payable is 11,000. How you calculated 11,000? In case of trader, tax is only on taxable supply of goods or taxable supply of services. So, for calculating aggregate turnover, you have to take total. For calculating permissible limit, you have to take both, taxable and exempt. But for calculating tax, come on, for calculating tax, you just have to take taxable supply of goods and taxable supply of services. Okay, so here, taxable supply of goods is, okay, matlab goods 20 plus 2 and a 22 lakhs CGST or SGST on 22 lakhs, 11,000 CGST and 11,000 SGST. In this way, I have calculated. Try to present this problem carefully. So, it's better, instead of reading this problem, if you try to solve it, that would be more better. Okay. Now, same for Goa. For Goa, you are within permissible limit of services, that is 5 lakhs. Turnover in state of Goa of preceding financial year is 18 lakhs, that is 1.8, or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. I have taken 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. Your services in current financial year is within permissible limit. Okay, so yes, your aggregate turnover is 55 and 3.5. And you have to calculate okay tax only on taxable supply. So, aapka total aggregate turnover kitna ho gaya? 30 plus 3, 33 plus 55 plus 3.5. Theek hai. It's still below 1.5 CR. Third one, Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh. Again same, your limit is 12 lakhs. How we calculated 12 lakhs? Because Madhya Pradesh turnover in state is 120 lakhs given in question. So, 5 lakhs or 12 lakhs, whichever is higher, 12 lakhs. And exact your total is 12 lakhs. Okay, you are within permissible limit. And your aggregate turnover 44, 12. Done. Tax only on this 40 lakhs and 10 lakhs. Okay, clear? So your aggregate turnover of all units is 148.5 lakhs below 150 lakhs. So your tax liability is as 1% of all this, which I have calculated in the note given below. This is the logic behind that. Very good problem. Okay. Yes, at difficult level, I have taken this problem. So you must refer this problem. Next, question number 31. Mr. Zaid, a registered in Himachal Pradesh, is engaged in making interest supplies of apparels. The aggregate turnover of Mr. Zaid in financial year 18-19 is 70 lakhs. He opted for composition levy in year 2019-20 and paid the tax for a quarter ending June 2019 under composition levy. The proper officer has levied the penalty of Mr. Zaid in addition to tax payable by him. You are required to examine the validity of action taken by a proper officer. Now, go slowly. Open your book. Now, in that book, read section 10.2, conditions for availment of ITC. Okay? In that condition, one of the condition is that if you engage in interstate outward supply of goods, then composition scheme is not available. I repeat, composition scheme is not available. Okay. Then read the section 10.5. Yes. Section 10.5. Section 10.5 said, I repeat, section 10.5 said, if composition levy is taken by any person which actually not available, then action under section 73 and 74, that is recovery of tax and penalty, shall be levied. So, in given case, if there is an interstate outward supply, even though aggregate turnover below 1.5 CR, but benefit should not be given. I repeat, benefit of composition levy should not be given because there is an interstate outward supply. But in first quarter, Mr. Zaid has paid the tax, okay, under composition levy, which is actually not available. Hence, under section 10.5, penalty would be leviable, and that penalty, I repeat, that penalty is as per section 73 and section 74. Action taken by the department is correct in law. Okay, taken by the department is correct in law. So, mainly you have to refer section 10.1, that is aggregate turnover below 1.5 CR, 10 condition interstate outwards, 10 penalty, here the then penalty is payable. An explanation, okay, yes, he is not eligible for composition scheme. Okay, so this question mainly based on penalty. Done, beta? So there is nothing, any special adjustment in this question. Next, question number 33. Bansal and Chandak is a partnership firm of chartered accountant in Jaipur, Rajasthan. The firm specializes in a bank audit, providing services to bank across the India. So it is a chartered accountant, audit service and etc. He is providing across the India. It has an annual turnover of rupees 110 lakhs in preceding financial year. With reference to the provision of CGST Act 2017, examine whether firm can offer composition scheme And will your answer change if A and B and etc.? Now, my first question here, again, open 10-2. In given case, a supplier is a supplier of services only and not doing any supply of goods, hence not eligible for composition scheme under section 10-1. Hence, he has to go for notification 2-2009, which comment you have to write here about notification 2019. Okay, I have not given that clause, but you will find one correction sheet on my webpage www.vsmartacademy.com/vishalsir, and on that my webpage, yes, you can refer the corrected sheet where I have added notification to 2009, especially in a case where purely service provider. So in this case, under section 10-1, he is only a service, hence composition scheme is not available. Also, his aggregate turnover of preceding financial year is more than 50 lakhs under notification to 2019, which a composition levy for supplier of service. So if turnover exceeds 50 lakhs, then again composition scheme is not available. Okay, so in both the cases composition levy is not available. Answer is correct, beta. There is no discussion. He is not eligible for composition scheme, but just you have to add one line more that under notification to 2019, okay, he is not eligible. So that correction sheet you will get on www.vsmartacademy.com/vishalsir. Please don't give any comment on YouTube, because this is a new law, beta. Continuous changing law, continuous new interpretation are coming, and I am trying my to keep you updated. मेरे लिए भी बहुत सारी प्रैक्टिकल डिफ़िकल्टीज है क्योंकि मुझे बैच 6 महीने पहले स्टार्ट करना पड़ता है, बहुत से नोटिफिकेशंस क्लैरिफिकेशंस बाद में आते हैं, मुझे बैच के साथ क्वेश्चनर्स देना पड़ता है, तो आई एम ट्राइंग माय बेस्ट. ओके, बट यस, दिस डिस्कशन विल हेल्प यू. द अनदर वन, विल योर आंसर चेंज इफ टर्नओवर ऑफ द फर्म इज 90 लाख? नथिंग, बिकॉज टर्नओवर of the firm again ultimately is a supplier of the service, hence benefit is not available under this notification under section 10. And under 2019 aggregate turnover exceeds 50 lakhs, again benefit is not available. If here instead of 90 that would have given as a lakhs notification to 2019 eligible for composition scheme. Okay, but 90 lakhs, no change in answer. Bansal and Chandak, B. Bansal and Chandak is not a partnership firm of chartered accountant, but a partnership firm providing support services to restaurant like booking, tablets, advertisement, etc. Now, try to understand. If you see this word carefully, then they are not providing restaurant or catering services. Come on, they are not providing restaurant or catering services. They are providing support service to restaurant. Again, don't get confused. Support service to restaurant. That means normal service. If it could be if it would be a restaurant service, then up to 150 CR they can take the ITC. But actually, it is not a restaurant service. It is support service to restaurant. Hence, again under 10, benefit is not available. And under 2019, their turnover exceeds, their turnover exceeds, what, beta? Their turnover exceeds 50 lakhs, hence composition levy is not available. So this is answers. Again, refer, correction sheet. You can download from www.vsmartacademy.com/vishalsir. And from there, I have added a comment of notification to 2019 at various places. You can refer that. It's not a mistake, beta. It's the answer with reference to 2019. I hope you understood. Next, beta, question number 34. Shubhalakshmi Foods is engaged in supplying restaurant service in Maharashtra. Underline, restaurant service in Maharashtra. In the past, there's a turnover of rupees 90 lakhs from restaurant service and 10 lakhs from supply of farm labor in a said state. Okay. Restaurant and 10 lakhs farm labor in a further, it has also earned a bank interest of rupees 10 lakhs from the fixed deposit. Means, restaurant service 90 lakhs, farm labor 10 lakhs, and interest, if you see, interest 10 lakhs. Interest is 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs, interest 10 lakhs. Shubhalakshmi Food wishes to offer composition scheme in current year. But required by Shubhalakshmi. Okay. Would your answer different if Shubhalakshmi Food is engaged in mailing of paddy into rice in farm labor and the term activity is 9 lakhs? Okay. We will give the second answer later on. First, go slowly. Open your book. Yes, open your book. Now, section 10.1. If aggregate turnover preceding financial year does not exceed 1.5 CR, then composition levy is available under section 10.1 to 3 persons, manufacturer, restaurant and catering, and next, restaurant catering and other suppliers. Okay, so all these 3 persons are eligible for composition scheme. Rate is 1%, 5% and 1%. Make 50-50 for CGST and SGST. One proviso is added, proviso 2 by CGST Amendment Act. What is that proviso? Now, a supplier under clause A or clause B or clause C, under clause A or B or C, that means manufacturer, okay, read that proviso with me, manufacturer or restaurant or catering or the trader, other supplier may supply services to the extent of 10% or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. 10% of turnover state. In bracket, after may supply of services, you will find in bracket other than clause B of para 6 of schedule, clause B of para 6 of schedule 2. It means for restaurant and catering that 10% criteria is not applicable. That is default allowed. Now, what is important? Go slowly. Take a clear understanding of the concept. Then design your answers. Read the answers. Make the framework. Every time I am saying to you, please, okay, here 100% attention is needed. So, okay, see beta, okay, now a time is 11:30 p.m. I am recording this lecture. Might be you will see me as exhausted because from morning I am taking booster classes, then my office, then consultancy. Afternoon I have recorded amendment for IPC. Evening I recorded questionnaire for you. And now 11:30 I am recording, okay, these questions of composition scheme. So, okay, I need your attention. Now, okay, along with restaurant and catering, you can supply a service that 10% of turnover in state or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. In that proviso, they said supply any service up to 10%. That means if your service is exempted, that would also be considered in that criteria limit 10% or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. But, okay, in amendment, you have seen there is a special order. That order supersedes the earlier order. supersedes the earlier order. But what is the new order? For calculation, for deciding the limit, that permissible limit of services, don't consider interest. Also, don't consider interest in aggregate turnover. So, okay. Now restaurant catering 90 lakhs is within limit, that because currently 1.5 CRI is available. And supply of other service, even though farm labor is exempted, but the other service is 10 lakhs. Supply of other service is 10 lakhs. Even though it is, but okay, should be added for calculation of limit. I hope you understood. So, if we assume, because your permissive in top turnover in state of preceding financial year. Now, your question, sir, how to calculate 10% of turnover of preceding financial year? Because turnover of preceding financial year is not given in the problem. Hence, you have to answer this, you have to answer in this area that we assume that a supply of farm labor of rupees 10 lakhs is within permissible limit. If you take such assumption, then yes. Okay. The composition scheme is available, okay, to Shubhalakshmi Foods Limited. And that interest should not be taken for the purpose of calculation, which is given by special order. Okay. Second one. Would your answer is different if Shubhalakshmi Food is engaged in milling of paddy into rice on job work basis instead of supply of farm labor and turnover from the said activity is 9 lakhs? No, answer would not be different. Okay, even though here that 9 lakhs, again milling of paddy into rice on job work basis is a taxable service. It's not an intermediary service for agriculture. Okay. What I am saying, you will understand, if you open the chapter of exemption, in exemption, agriculture sector, pause this lecture, go to agriculture sector exemption, in that there is one exemption. Intermediary production process in relation to agriculture. And you will find one clarification in this regard that milling of paddy into rice is not intermediary production process, hence exemption is not available. So is it a taxable service? If it is a taxable service, so whatever you are the service, it may be exempt or taxable, it should be within permissible limit. So you have to take the assumption that it is in within permissible limit. So if 9 lakh is within permissible limit, then you can continue your composition scheme because your aggregate turnover below 1.5 CR. I hope you understood. Aggregate turnover below 1.5 CR. You can take the exemption for that. But beta, okay. See, author note I have given. Because when... I took this answer from RTP, but okay, new order came as well as CGST Amendment Act came. Particularly for this answer, I repeat, my questionnaire is completely updated. But for this answer, the clarification of that interest came after printing of this answer. So, okay, the correct answer. Don't read this answer. Okay, the correct answer you will find in that correction list. In correction list, again I repeat, on www.vsmartacademy.com/vishalsir, where the 3 points, as per proviso 210(1), supply of any service up to 10% of turnover in state, okay, is allowed with restaurant or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. Second, we are saying that a supply of farm labor, a service is within permissible limit of 10%. Hence, okay, composition scheme is available under section 10. Third, okay, interest should not be excluded as per the special order given by the CBIC. Just a very small, okay, answers after amendment. This answer is not wrong, but it based on earlier circular and not a circular which is superseded, okay, which we had discussed in amendments. So I will give, as per news order, the answer you will find in correction sheet. That's all better. This is question number 34. Next, question number 37. Mr. X, a trader, underline the word, a trader, eligible for composition scheme in a financial year 18-19 on his turnover of preceding year 68 lakhs. They have given he is eligible for composition scheme. Okay, no issue. April to Mr. Raj worth rupees 2,50,000. Okay, here to Mr. Veer 7,50,000. 20th May to Samir 22 lakhs. And 22nd May supply of service to Tushar. Supply of service to Tushar 2,20,000. Okay, calculate GST payable by Mr. X and whether Mr. X is eligible for the composition scheme after 22nd May 18. And after this, now again this problem we already had discussed in amendment. If you remember earlier, supply of any service was not allowed, but today after introduction of second proviso to CGST Amendment Act, you can supply the service up to 10% or 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. Now, okay, turnover of preceding financial year is 68 lakhs. I repeat, turnover of preceding financial year is 68 lakhs. Okay. The 10% of 68 lakhs is 6.8 lakhs or rupees 5 lakhs, whichever is higher. So, here 6.8 lakhs is your permissible limit. You have provided service of rupees 2,20,000, yani below the permissible limit. Hence, your composition scheme shall not be withdrawn. Still, you are within limit. So, okay, you have to pay tax at composition rate. In given problem, he is a trader. Open your book. Okay, if he is a trader, then applicable rate is 1% of taxable goods and services. So, in given problem, all goods are taxable. So, 1% of this plus for services also 1%. Because within permissible limit, whatever the services you provide, the tax is payable at the rate 1%. I repeat, tax is payable at the rate 1%. So, if you, okay, that legal provision I have explained first. If you see, then, okay, here, for supply of goods, 0.5% CGST and 0.5% SGST, that calculated. But do one correction in the problem, which is very important. What is the correction? A service also, because supply of service, that is 2,25,000, it also payable at the rate 5% and 0.5%. And calculate the amount accordingly. So in this case, okay, there is one correction by mistake. It would have taxes, it would have calculated, okay, sorry, by mistake it is calculated, okay, at the rate 9%, it should not be at the rate 9%, it should be at 0.5%, because the services, whatever you provided is within permissible limit. I hope you understood. Yes, this is the mistake, beta. Okay, typological mistake is there. So, this is a question 37.